Welcome to the instructional video for the CUE app and CUE1 Bluetooth connection. I'll be taking you through how to set everything up and get connected. The CUE1 is a non-invasive wearable device that uses vibration to alleviate a range of Parkinson's symptoms, including slowness and stiffness of movement and freezing of gait. It can be used as a completely standalone device, but can also be used in concert with our CUE app. By connecting your CUE1 to the app via Bluetooth, you can alter the characteristics of the vibration it delivers to suit your personal preference. The app also has some other features, like medication reminders, symptom tracking, and games, and will include more as we update the app over time. In this video, we'll go through how to connect your CUE1 to the app and start altering the stimulation settings. First of all, please download the CUE app from the App Store on Apple devices and the Google Play Store on Android devices. You can use a phone or tablet, whichever is your preference. When you first open the app, you'll be asked to create a profile using your email, Google, or Apple account. This is to gather some initial info on your symptoms, exercise, and diet, and will help track any data you choose to enter into the app to show your healthcare team or just for your own interest. After completing your profile, you'll be taken through some basic setup steps, starting on this page. When you tap Next, you'll be asked, would you like to connect to a CUE1? If you don't want to connect to a CUE1, please tap No. If you are ready with your CUE1, please tap Yes. Continue through the steps until you reach this page, where the app will search for your CUE1. If you have changed your mind and don't want to connect to a CUE1, you can simply tap Skip Pairing for now. If your CUE1 is active and nearby, it should appear on the screen like this. If you only have one CUE1 device, you don't need to check the serial number. If your app cannot find any devices, please make sure your phone or tablet's Bluetooth is turned on in settings, and try turning your CUE1 off and then on again by pressing the CUE1 button or place your CUE1 on charge on the dock. Once the app has found your device, please tap on it to connect. This should result in a short spinning blue light animation on the CUE1 device. You will then be able to rename your CUE1 to make it easier to identify in your app for the future. After you have gone through the initial setup process, from then on, the app should connect to your CUE1 automatically when opened, as long as the CUE1 is nearby and advertising Bluetooth. To make sure it is advertising Bluetooth, simply press the button to turn the CUE1 off and on again, or place the CUE1 on charge. At the top of the app's home screen, you should be able to see the CUE1 connected sign, along with the battery indicator showing the CUE1's current battery level when connected. If your CUE1 is not currently connected to the app, you will see a screen like this. If you ever need to repeat the connection setup process, for example, to connect to a different CUE1 device, or if you are having trouble connecting to your CUE1, just press on the battery indicator at the top of the homepage to see the device status and tap the Connect to Different CUE1 button. The app will disconnect from your CUE1 automatically after a few minutes of inactivity or if you quit the app. Once your CUE1 is connected, you will be able to alter the stimulation settings, which you may wish to do to match the CUE1 to your personal comfort preferences or potentially improve its efficacy. Access this feature by tapping the Stimulation Settings tile on the home screen, or Stimulation tab at the bottom of the app. Here you will see three sliders that you can tap and drag to increase or decrease. Strength adjusts the intensity of the vibration. Pulse length sets how long each pulse of vibration is, whilst rest length sets how long the gap between each pulse is. These changes are shown visually on the graph at the top of the screen, which represents the pattern of the CUE1 vibration. Once you've adjusted the sliders, make sure to tap Apply or Save as New at the bottom of the screen. You may need to scroll down to see these. Pressing either of the buttons will change the current stimulation settings on your CUE1, but the Save as New function will also save this specific stimulation configuration on the application, so you can easily return to it in the future. To view your previously saved presets, tap on the Saved tab at the top of the screen. You can then apply any of these to your CUE1 by tapping on the preset. Everyone is different, and some may find certain stimulation settings more effective for their symptoms or simply more comfortable than others. Your CUE1 comes preloaded with settings that we've found are effective for many people, but we highly encourage you to try other settings to see what suits you, especially if you find the default settings less effective than you'd hoped for, or are having trouble getting used to the sensation. Some people prefer a softer vibration strength, while others even save specific presets for different activities, like exercise. If you would like any assistance or advice with this process, please do get in touch and we'll be happy to help. The other features of the app, namely the medication reminders, symptom tracker, symptom tracking games, and how are you feeling features, can be used even when the CUE1 is not connected to the app. We hope these will help everyone manage the fluctuations in their symptoms over time and communicate them to others with greater ease. We are continually working on the app and we will be adding new features soon, so please keep an eye out for updates. Additionally, if you have any feedback about the app, please do let us know. We'd love to hear your thoughts. We hope this guide has been helpful in setting up your CUE1's Bluetooth connection and getting started with the CUE app. If you have any questions or need any help, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us by emailing support@charconeurotech.com.